Hello everyone, welcome to the next session of our class Digital System Design. So in the last class we understood the Quine-McCluskey techniques and how to get a simplified equation for a given Boolean equation by using the Quine-McCluskey technique. So now by using the Quine-McCluskey techniques, so how to get a simplified equation for an incomplete specified function. So that means when we have a don't kill terms will be there, then how to get an simplified equation for a given Boolean function. Let's understand that one by solving one problem related to the incomplete functions. Okay, and the problem is, so the simplify the given Boolean function using Quine-McCluskey technique, minimization technique. So the problem is s equals to a 4 variable function ABCD. Okay, this is equals to summation of 1, 3, 13, 15 and summation of a don't care terms. So this indicated the don't care terms, d indicates what? Don't care terms 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, so this is the problem given. So the whatever the procedure we followed to solve the complete function, okay, the same procedure also followed here actually. But when we are considering a prime implicants table, okay, so the prime implicant consisting of only the don't care terms will not be considered. So don't care terms will be inconsidered when you are making the grouping actually. So that means when you are combining the mean terms, so 2 mean terms or 4 mean terms, when combining you are going to include the don't care terms. So let's understand by solving this problem. Okay, so as usual we need to create a table. Okay, so arranging the number of ones in the mean terms in the increasing order, so like that we need to create the table. Okay, so I will going to create a first table group mean terms variables. So variables are A, B, C, D. There is no zero group actually, because we don't have a mean term where the number of ones are zero. Okay, so next will be the mean term will be the one arranging in an increasing order, including the don't care terms. But since to specify this don't care term, we will go to indicate it with a star actually. Okay, so let's see. So 1 and next 8 will come, because number of ones in an 1 is 1 and the 8 is also 1, right? Yes, 8 to indicate is a don't care term. Okay, indicated with a star, so that we'll understand 8 is an don't care term. So this is the group 1. So what is 1? 0, 0, 0, 1, 8, 1, 0, 0, 0. Let's take the mean terms which having the two numbers of 1s. Next, if you look at the 3, the two numbers of 1s will be there. And the 9, again the two number of 1s. 10, two number of 1s will be there. So let's arrange that one. 3, so that is 0, 0, 1, 1. Next, 9. And it is an don't care term, so that's why we're going to indicate with a star. Okay, 1, 0, 0, 1. Next is 10. Again, 10 is an don't care term, so indicate with a star, and the 10 corresponds to the 1, 0, 1, 0. So this is the group 2, because we have a 2 logic ones in the mean terms. So this completes the next. We have a 11. 13, so this will come to the group 3, 11 star and 13, 11 corresponds to the 1, 0, 1, 1 and 13, 1, 1, 0, 1. Okay, next 15 mean term, and the number of ones in the mean term is 4, and that's why indicates with the group 4. 1, 1, 1, 1. So this is how we created a first table. Okay, now we need to combine the mean terms. A single mean terms will be combined with the next mean terms, that is about next group. So n group will be compared with the n plus 1 group and making to the 2 mean terms group. Okay, so let's create the second table group mean terms variables. Compare the group n with the n plus 1. Okay, so that means I will compare the mean term 1 with the mean term 3, 9, 8. Okay, so if you see, so these two are, we can able to compare, right? And here one thing is what, there only one variable is changing. If you see the C is 0 here and C is 1. So that means this should be identified as a dash and the remaining will be right as it is. Okay, so the mean terms group are here 1 and 3 can be grouped. So if you covered means usually will go with the tick mark, right? Okay, these two are covered actually. So and the variables are 0, 0 and the dash 1. Okay, so next we are going to compare the 1 with 9. Yes, 1 with can, if you can group, because only one variable changes there and the remaining variables are as it is. Okay, so that means dash 0, 0, 1. So we can 1 and the 9, where the 9 is crisp star because a don't kill term, and we can group. So the variables are dash 0, 0, 1. Next, 1 will be compared with 10. We can't able to group because 0, 1, 0, 1. Two variables are changing. So we are not able to group the mean terms 1 and 10. Okay. Next, 8 will compare with the 3, 9, 10. 8 with 3. Yes, we can group. No, actually, we are not able to group 8 with 3 because two variables will be changing. So next, 8 and 9. Yes, we can group 8, 9. Okay. So 8 star, 9 star, we can group, and the variables 1, 0, 0, dash, 1, 0, 0, dash. Next, 8 will compare with the 10. Yes, we can group because only one variable is changing. So and the variables are 1, 0, dash, 0, 1, 0, dash, 0, and the mean terms 8 star, 10 star. Okay, so this completes the group 1. Now let's compare the 2 with the group 3, group 2 with the group 3. So that means, so I will take the 3 and will compare with the 11. Okay, 3, 11. So yes, we can group each other, we can group these two, and the variables are dash 0, 1, 1. 3, 11, we can be group dash 0, 1, 1. Okay. Next, 3 will compare with 13. Can we group? No, we are not able to group. Okay. Next, 9 will compare with the 11. Yes, we can group. So the variables are 1, 0, dash 1, 1, 0, dash 1, and the mean terms 9, 11. Since don't kill terms will go indicated with the star. Next, 9 will compare with the 13. Can we group? Yes, we can group again. So 1 dash 0 1. 1 dash 0 1. 9 13. Next, 10 will compare with the 11. Yes, we can group. Okay, 1 0 1 dash 1 0 1 dash. So that is 10 will be grouped with the 11. Next, 10 with 13, we can't able to group. 0, 1, 1, 0, two variables are changing. So this completes the group 2. So next, let's compare the 3, group 3 with the group 4. So 11 will compare with the 15. Yes, we can group, because only one variable is changing. So that is 11 and 15 mean terms will can be grouped, and the variables are 1 dash 1 1, 1 dash 1 1. And next, 13 will compare with the 15. Again, we can be group these two because only one variable is changing, and the variables are 1 1 dash 1. And this is the group 3. So now created the table making the 2 mean terms group. Now we need to make a 4 mean terms group. So that means you're comparing the group 1 with the group 2, group 2 with the group 3 in the table 2 and make a new table. Okay. Now let's create the table. So combining the 4 mean terms. Okay. So that means here we are going to compare the group 1 with the group 2. Okay. So mean terms. So when you are comparing, so see, always we need to identify the same positions of dash, and that again we need to identify the any one variable changes there. So if you see this one, this can be compared with this only possible. So let's compare 0, 1, one variable change, 0, 0, 1, 1. So that means 1 comma 3 can be grouped with the, so on this 9, 11. So that means the mean terms are 1, 3, 9, 11, and the variables are dash 0, dash 1. Okay, next 1 comma 9. So the possible comparison is what? 1 comma 9 can be compared with the 3, 11, 0, dash 0, dash 1. So again we can be group. So that means 1, 3, dash 0, dash 1, right? Dash 0, dash 1. So there is 1, 9, 3, 11. 1, 9, 3, 11 is already is here actually. So it will be, if you write means, it will be repeated one. That is the note to be considered that one. Okay. So that is not needed. Then 8, 9. So this can be compared with the this one. Right? 1, 0, dash, dash. Yes. So this corresponds to 8, 9, 10, 11. 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, and the variables are 1, 0, dash, dash. 1, 0, dash, dash. So next you can compare the 8, 10. So if you take the 8, 10, so this can be compared with the here. So 1, 0, dash, dash. So this 1, 0, dash, dash, 1, 0, dash, dash, and the variables 8, 9, 10, 11 are already repeated here. 8, 9, 10, 11. So that means no need to write again. Okay. So this completes the comparison between the group 1 and the group 2. Let's see the group 2 with the group 3. So group 2 with group 3 means, so this here, the first group can be compared with anyone? No, we're not able to compare, and that means you're not able to group at all. Okay, and the second one, so 9, 11 can be compared with the 13, 15 because same position of the dash. Okay, next 1, 1, 0, 1, dash, dash, 1, 1. So that means we can group this one. 9, 11, 13, 15. 9, 11, 13, 15, where 9 and 11 are the don't care terms and the variables are 1, dash, dash, 1. Dash 1. Okay, next can we compare 9, 13? Yes, and this can be compared with the here 9, 13, 11, 15. 1, dash, dash 1, same thing will be there, right? So that means no need to repeat that one. Okay, next can we compare the 10, 11? No, we're not able to compare. So these are the only 4 mean terms. So this with the group 1 and this with the group 2. So the prime implicants are, so this is the mean terms. So mean terms 1, 3, 9, star, 11, star, this will be there, and the mean terms corresponding to here is what? B bar D. Okay, so and see 8, 9, 10, 11. So this is the one prime implicant actually, but where all the mean terms are will be a don't care terms. So that means this should not be able to consider as a prime implicant. So that means we are not able to consider these variables or this prime implicant. So another prime implicant available is 9, 11, 13, 15. So this corresponds to the 1, 1. So that is A, D. Okay. So in these two, which is essential, we need to identify it and we need to write the simplified equation. So that completes the problem. So next is the prime implicant table. So here we are going to write the prime implicants. Okay, decimal notations. And then we are going to write the mean terms. So mean terms which are given actually. So the mean terms which are given are 1, 3, 13, 15. Okay, so the prime implicants B bar D, A D, the decimals notations 1, 3, 9, 11. Next 9, 11, 13, 15. Okay, so this prime implicant will going to cover the prime mean terms 1 and the mean term 3. Similarly, the second prime implicant AD will going to cover the 13 and 15. Okay, so this means actually, so only one entry in each column, right? So that means all the prime implicants are essential. So essential prime implicants are B bar D and A D. So that means the simplified equation, that is S equals to B bar D bar plus A D. So this is how we are going to solve an unspecified function or a don't care functions using the Quinn McCluskey minimization technique. But keep in mind, any prime implicant consisting only the don't care terms would not be able to consider. When we are solving the KMAP also, we won't group the don't care terms completely. When we have only one with the don't care terms, we will go to group. But only don't care terms, we have 4 cells or 8 cells, we won't group, right? The same way, because these mean terms not able to make an essential prime implicant. So that's why a prime implicant made by the only the don't cares will not be considered. Yeah, till now we discussed about the how to simplify the given Boolean equation by using the Quinn-McCluskey technique. So now, so if you recall the sequence actually, so what with the designing of a combinational circuit sequence, so problem statement will be given. From the problem statement, so we have constructed the truth table. Okay, then so we have written the Boolean equations from the truth table, and then so equations can be simplified by using the different techniques. So we can use simplify by using the Boolean techniques, Boolean simplification method, or by using the KMAP, or by using the Quinn-McCluskey technique. Then after the simplified equations, we need to write the logic diagram. Okay, let's come to that part. Let's take a problem where we are going to cover the all the sequence of a designing of any combinational circuits. So the problem is, design a 3 input 1 output minimal gate combinational circuit. So which has an output 1, so output will be 1 when the majority of its inputs are at logic 1. What is the sequence actually? Problem statement is given, we need to write the truth table. From the truth table, we need to get the simplified equation. From the simplified, by using the any simplification technique or KMAP or Quinn-McCluskey technique, anything, okay. And then we need to write the logic circuit diagram, okay. So let's, whatever the problem statement will be given, let's convert the into the truth table. So as the problem statement only says actually there are 3 inputs, right? So we will name these 3 inputs as an A, B, C. Okay, and there is a 1 output. I will name the 1 output as a Y. So 3 inputs means actually combinations. So there is 2 to the power of 3, that will be 8 combinations will be there. So 8 combination truth table we need to be construct. Okay, let's construct that one. Truth table. So this input, this is output. Okay, so 8 combinations, so which are 000 001 010. Okay, so according to the problem actually, what is what? So output will be 1 when we have the majority of the inputs are at logic 1. So that means, so here 0, 0, 0, the majority is what? Logic 0. So that means output will be 0. 0, 0, 1, 2 inputs are 0. So output will be 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. See, 2 inputs are logic 1. So majority are inputs are logic 1. So output will be 1. Next, it will be 0, 1, 1, 1. So now, let's have the canonical expression also. So y is equals to f of a comma b comma c equals to summation of. So what is the switching equation? So that is 0, wherever the logical output will be 1. So see, summation and rotation I am writing, that means mean time expression I am writing. So that means wherever the output will be generated 1, the corresponding inputs will be indicated in an decimal form. So that means the output will be, so which are all the equations will be there, switching equations, 3, 5, 6, 7, 3, 5, 6, 7. So this is what the switching equation, okay. Now from the switching equation, we will go to write the K map and let's get the simplified expression for the given problem. So let's have the K map. So there is a second step, this one, and this, now we are moving to the third step. So 3 inputs, that means we'll have an 8 cell K map. So A, B, C, A can take a 0, 1, and B, C can take a 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. The cell and the cell numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So according to this two table or a problem statement, wherever the 3, 5, 6, 7 will be there, cells in the K map, that will going to generate the logic 1 and the remaining will be the logic 0. So that's what the two table going to say as per the problem statement. So according to this two table, the K map will be, so 3, 5, 7, 3, 5, 7 and the 6 will be logic 1 and the remaining cells will be logic 0. Now we should have the simplified equation. So that means we need to get a simplified equation, we need to be grouping. Okay. So the possible groups. So this is the one group, and this is the one group, and again this is the one group. Right? So two logical ones can be grouped. So we have a three groups. So we'll name this as a G1, G2, and the G3. Okay. So what is the G1? So mean terms in a variables correspond to here, A has changed over, so A won't appear here actually for the G1. So that is equals to BC. I am writing in the mean terms in variables. So G2, so expression for the G2 group, so A, C has changed over, we are not able to consider that variable because there is a changeover. So that means corresponds to the AB, right? Next G3, the expression for the G3 is A, and in this B has a changeover, so only C will come. So the expression is the C. So that means the simplified expression for the given function, so that is Y equals to the BC plus AB plus AC. So this is the simplified equation. Now we need to construct a logic diagram, okay, for this simplified equation. So let's construct that one. So this covers the complete sequence. Okay, see, problem statement is converted into the two table is converted into the switching equation is going to be simplified, okay, by using the K map. From this one we're going to develop a logic circuit. Okay, so A and B, C are the inputs. Now let's write the circuit diagram for this simplified equation. So which are all the inputs we have? A, B, C. So first we need a AND gate to implement the term BC. So B and C will be AND. And next, to implement the A into B, we need an AND gate. A and the B will be AND. Next, A, C, A, and the C will be AND, and all these things will be ORed. And this will going to give a, so this will go give a AB, and this will give a BC, and this AND gate will give a AC. All this will be ORed. AB plus BC plus AC, and this is equals to Y. So this is how we will going to convert a simplified equations to the a switching circuit, okay, or we can call the a logical circuit, okay. So this is how a combination circuit will be a design. Find the problem statement. So problem state will be converted to two table to the switching equation to the simplified equation by using the any techniques, and then we will going to write the logic diagram. Okay, so this is what the first module. Okay, so this will covers the all the topics in the first module. Thank you.